What happens when you take a small basic hatchback and turn it into arguably one of the most fun front-wheel drive cars ever? You get this. Introducing the Ford Fiesta ST, otherwise known as the Fist. With most hot hatches focusing on how fast you can exit out of a corner or go from 0 to 100, this car does something at the outside of a Miata is very rare to see. Feel fun at all times. This is due to two simple reasons. Incredibly agile handling, as it's lightweight, has a short wheelbase and very quick steering, and of course, a very responsive and torquey engine made it to a 6-speed manual, so you could feel like you're going 60 miles an hour when you're only going 40. Now, let's think of the Fiesta ST as a simple vanilla cake. When you cut into that cake, you can start to see the various layers of depth and nuance to it that of course you couldn't see at first glance. This is exactly the Fiesta ST, as underneath the skin of an unassuming small hatch is a level of engineering that is quite surprising. And this is exactly what we'll be covering in an Automotive X-ray of this car. Each section of this video will be divided into the various mechanical parts of the car, such as the engine, gearbox, dynamics, suspension, and of course, the chassis and underbody. With that being said, let's begin. At first glance, the EcoBoost 1.6-litre turbo which powers this particular automobile looks like your cookie-cutter 4-cylinder turbo direct injection engine, making 180 horsepower at 6,500 RPM and 244 Nm and 2,600 to 5,000 RPM. But you do get some pretty neat overboost of 17 more horsepower for 15 seconds. Fun fact, in the US, the Fiesta ST was marketed as having the full 197 horsepower, but down under and in the UK were actually not allowed to market an engine's temporary output. But as we dive deeper, we'll soon realize this engine is far from ordinary. And with that, let's start from the basic building blocks with, of course, the engine block. It's a high-strength aluminium alloy block which uses thin wall casting in low-stress areas to keep the weight down. And the focus on the lightweight engine continues with the block being an open deck design which makes sure the cylinders are cooled properly, as we can see here with a crosshatch finish in the cylinder walls. So we have the foundations of the engine. But to make power, we need pistons, and in the EcoBoost 1.6, they are hyper-eutectic, with the unmachined surfaces of these cast pistons having a near-machined finish. And the piston pins use a diamond-like coating, so the pistons can last very long. To actually get the pistons to move, we need connecting rods, and on the EcoBoost 1.6, a hot-forged, powdered metal process and cracked rod cap process is used to make these high-strength rods. So far, so good. But what makes this engine different from other 4-cylinders on the market? Well, while some other 4-cylinder engines, such as the FA20 and the F20C, have a two-piece design to the cam journals, the EcoBoost 1.6-litre keeps the lower cam journals as part of the casting. As a result, the cylinder head ports, valve design, and combustion chamber are designed for high velocity flow and exceptional combustion efficiency. To allow the intake flow to be quickly turned from the plastic intake manifold into the cylinders, all 8 intake ports feature a visible D-shaped design. Plastic intake manifolds are becoming more and more common on modern engines as they are lightweight and easier to manufacture and mass produce, and this particular design in the Fiesta ST is designed to last forever under boost. Speaking of the intake manifold, a sound symposium tube is attached to it and even extends into the cabin to make this car sound better than it does on the outside. Let's see for ourselves, shall we, as we give this car the beans on the Great Ocean Road. actually not too bad for a sound for a 4-cylinder turbo. Dare I say, slightly impressive. Back to the video. If we have a look at the center hole of this combustion chamber, this is actually for the direct injection this car uses, meaning fuel is injected directly into the cylinder through a high pressure mechanical fuel pump, which was driven by an additional load within one of the camshafts. This means the Fiesta ST can run a relatively high compression ratio of 10.1 to 0 without risking engine knock like older port injection engines. The theme of maximizing flow continues in even the smallest details, like using a smaller valve stem diameter, which in the EcoBoost 1.6 is 5mm, and for reference, one of the smallest valve stem diameters fitted to a 4-cylinder engine is 6.5mm in the legendary B-series engines. So, what about the valves? They're 30mm in size for the intake valves, whilst the exhaust valves are 25mm, with the intake valves using a black nitrate coating for a longer stem life. We now know how big the valves are, but how do they work? Through using twin independent variable camshaft timing on both the intake and exhaust camshafts instead of a conventional VCT setup which only worked on a single camshaft, you got improved power and torque, which is why many owners often praise this engine for having quite a torquey bottom end, and of course, great fuel economy and reduced emissions. Now we have the inner workings of the engine, but as we know, a lot of owners will probably take this car to autocross or racetrack. We need to keep a constant supply of engine oil around the oil pump's pickup assembly so that the engine doesn't starve itself of oil and go kaboom. The oil pan fits this brief to the T, and in the EcoBoost 1.6 litre, this is an aluminium oil pan which also adds structural support between the engine and the transaxle assembly. So far, we've gone through this car's compression ratio and all that type of jazz, but what truly gives it its power? A KP39 low inertia, water-cooled BorgWarner turbo, which makes 19 PSI on overboost and around 16 to 17 when not on it. Unlike other EcoBoost engines that use a turbofold turbocharger system where the turbine housing is cast as part of the exhaust manifold, the turbo in this engine is attached to a separate cast iron exhaust manifold to help the engine meet Euro 5 standards. To regulate this boost, a massive actuator and integral water gate assembly has been used, and the ECU optimizes the actuation of the compressor bypass so you don't get compressor surge, which can damage the turbo over time. Also controlled by the ECU is a 52mm drive-by-wire throttle body. With all that technical mumbo-jumbo out of the way, let's talk about the changes made to the EcoBoost 1.6 over the Fiesta ST's life cycle. First up, the cylinder head. Whilst this is quite a robust design from the factory, the Fiesta ST is known to suffer from overheating issues on the track, and one owner even ended up cracking the cylinder heads as he was running a bigger turbo and maybe even meth injection on his setup. With this overheating leading to a cracked block and subsequent oil leak in mind, Ford changes design for 2016 by modifying the coolant passageways so there's no hotspot in the cylinder head, causing engine failure. Earlier in this section, we talked about direct injection and how Ford can run a pretty high compression ratio for a small engine without running into engine knock. Unfortunately, there's a catch, as when you shoot fuel directly into the cylinder, it never hits the intake valves, and as fuel acts as a cleaning detergent to the valves in older engine designs, the high heat inside these engines means the valve can build up with carbon over time. We cover this issue in huge detail in our carbon build-up video, which you can check out over here. Luckily, in 2016, Ford decided to change the intake plumbing inside the crankcase ventilation system to try to prevent carbon buildup on the intakes. While Ford added a slightly more burbly rear muffler to give it a bit more zing in the sound department, one big change Ford made to the Fiesta ST in 2016 is stiffening those rear motor mounts to try and address that torque steam you get when the engine vibrates quite a bit. When you combine this with an open differential which doesn't put the power down evenly compared to a limited slip differential, torque steer is inevitable. We've also covered this issue in quite a lot of detail on our torque steer video, which you can check out over here. We have an engine, but we need something so it operates at its best at any speed. So let's now talk about the transmission. As we mentioned very early in this video, there's only one type of transmission that comes with this car, and luckily, it's the right one. A 6-speed zero-shift B6 manual which features Ford's torque vectoring control system to brake the inside front wheel to aid agility. If we have a quick look at the gear ratios here, at first glance, first and second gear, looks quite long, but as the final drive ratio is actually very short at 3.82, this makes first gear actually very short, and the other gears are spaced pretty close to each other, with 6th gear being long to cruise at decently low RPMs, but not too long, so acceleration will feel dead at that gear. Let's now move on to one of the biggest aspects of what makes this car so special, the dynamics. Let's start with the steering. It's an electric rack and pinion setup, which is actually very fast, with a steering ratio reduced from 14.6 to 1 for the standard Mark 6 Fiesta to 13.69 to 1. As a result of this quick steering and a very small wheelbase of 24.89mm, 98 inches, the Fiesta ST has quite a small turning circle of 11.2 meters. This is why the Fiesta ST handles like a monkey ninja on steroids on a twisty mountainous road that we've just embarked on. How about the brakes? Whilst the brakes themselves are decently sized at 278mm by 23mm vented at the front and 253mm by 10mm solid at the rear, the calipers are quite small at 54mm at the front and 34mm at the rear, with complaints that the brakes feel very touchy and responsive even when you're not fully braking it at 100%. Our theory is that Ford engineered the braking response this way to master small brake caliper design. Before we talk some quick shop about the alignment and camber changes from the regular Fiesta, the wheels are 17 inch by 7 and they're fitted on some Bridgestone 205/40 R17 84W tyres, which have pretty thin sidewalls that give it a really good front end grip that help it not understeer even at the limit. Now, with the alignment, shall we? Firstly, the Fiesta ST runs less negative rear camber than the regular Fiesta to help get it to rotate quicker on corner entry. The caster is very positive, meaning that when the more you steer it, the more negative camber you get as you turn into a corner, meaning more grip. But despite that torque vectoring control, the lack of LSD is quite a drawback considering how much power this car makes for this chassis. So whilst on corner entry, this car is very fast to turn in with that quick steering ratio, negative rear camber and positive caster. On corner exit, it's a different story, as it can't pull all that power down. Luckily, in the later generation Fiesta ST, which North America didn't get, they introduced an LSD to deal with this issue. And if we look at the weight and cross balance of the Fiesta ST from Savage Geese, this is actually very good, being almost 50% cross weight. In front wheel drive setups, this is quite hard to achieve, as front wheel drive engines are almost always transverse, meaning it's placed horizontally instead of vertically, meaning the left slash right balance will always be slightly off. Front rear balance as well is actually quite good as well, being at 60.3/39.7, and this is due to the EcoBoost 1.6 litre having a very light dry weight of 114 kilos. Let's now move on to the quads and hammies of the Fiesta ST, the suspension. Just like the engine, at first glance, you would think this is some basic Econobox suspension. A simple strut front and a torsion beam rear axle. This is what journos call cost cutting at its finest. But in the Fiesta ST, the suspension is actually ace. So ace that you have some owners saying this car almost handles like rear wheel drive the way it can lift off oversteer. Before we get to why it can handle like that at the limit, let's first go over the front suspension. It uses L-shaped lower wishbones, and until the 16th of February 2016, it ran a 3K front spring rate and used a 90mm diameter stabilizer bar, as well as a modified steering knuckle from the factory. But the true magic is in that rear suspension, especially that rear twist beam, which is so stiff at 7.5mm thickness. In fact, 75% stiffer than the regular Fiesta, a Ford didn't even need to fit a rear sway bar from the factory. And the reason why they can feel almost rear wheel drive for a front wheel drive is due to a stiffer spring rate at the rear for a small front wheel drive car at 2.55K. But with great handling, unfortunately comes sacrifices on the street, with the ride being infamous for being quite stiff on the roughest of roads. So address some of those complaints, Ford softened the bushings for 2015, but the biggest changes came on the 16th of February 2016. This is where Ford went all out and softened suspension all around by 33%. However, to keep the liftoff oversteer giggles of the pre-2016 Fiesta STs, Ford fitted a 19mm pierced beam stiffener, which alone adds 24% torsional stiffness, as well as increasing the rear torsion beam and front anti-roll bar stiffness by that same 33%. With all that suspension mumbo jumbo out of the way, let's now delve deep into the final pieces of the puzzle, the chassis and underbody. As expected, with a spicy Econo box like the Fiesta ST, it's a pretty cheap chassis made out of stainless steel. In fact, the chassis outside of the suspension setup is all shared with the regular Fiesta ST. However, the control arms are different on the Fiesta ST, and the rear ST bushings are a different diameter due to the beams being bigger than the non-ST. As a result, the ST runs a 15mm lower body height than the base Fiesta, and we assume this is to reduce the center of gravity for less body roll in the twisties. One thing they will point out when looking at this underbody is that servicing this car is quite easy, as there aren't any covers you need to unscrew if you wish to do simple oil changes. Finally, in 2016, wind deflectors were added to the molding between both front triangular windows and the main front windows, near the side view mirrors, to move some turbulence away from the door seal and reduce wind noise, as well as contribute to an even lower drag coefficient than the already quite low 0.32 on the 2014 Fiesta ST, which is one of the reasons why it sips feel like a retired couple on a holiday on the beach. So, real world performance time. Despite finishing last in the 2017 Lightning Lap, it was only 1 second slower than the much more powerful 2008 WRX XTI and Mazda RX-8, and with a fair amount of straights, it was always going to struggle in terms of top end power compared to the rest. We feel the Fiesta ST is a much better steer on autocross, where corner entry is king and it's just corners galore. Let's now head into concluding remarks. Overall, what are my thoughts on the Fiesta ST? It's amazing how cheap this car is on the used market, with examples in Australia going for just over $10,000. For a car that's roughly 10 years old, has amazingly fun handling and a very fun powertrain, whilst being practical enough to take the groceries and a few of your mates down for a late night Macca's run, it's an amazing price to pay. We live in an era where our roads are littered with speed cameras at every corner, and little nuggets like this, which feel fun at every speed, are such a fun brush of air, with so many modern hot hatches focusing on performance instead of fun giggles and frills like the old days. Thanks everyone for tuning in and leaving kind words and incredibly helpful advice in the comments to help improve our automotive x-rays. Let us know what cars you want us to do next, and I'll see you in a bit.